Good morning, everyone.
All right.
Let's begin by ringing the bell three times. And we'll let that sound and vibration awaken us into this moment, into our bodies, together in our practice. Fulfilling prayer to Padmasambhava, and we'll follow that by our refuge prayer once in Tibetan and three times in English.
Usom Sangye Guru Rinpo Che Nundru Kunda Deva Chen.
And source of all spiritual accomplishments, fierce destroyer of illusion who dispels every obstruction, we pray to you for blessing, inspiration, and realization. Please remove all outer, inner, and secret obstacles and spontaneously fulfill our aspirations.
Sangye Chodong Tsoki Choknam La Jongchu Bardu Dakni Kapsu Chi Dakji Jinso Ki Pei Sunam Ki Drola Pinchir Sangye Drupar Sho.
In Buddha, Dharma, and Sangha, we go for refuge until fully awakened through the power of generosity, ethics, patience, enthusiastic effort, concentration, and wisdom. For the sake of all beings, may we realize and demonstrate our innate goodness. In Buddha, Dharma, and Sangha, we go for refuge until fully awakened. Through the power of generosity, ethics, patience, enthusiastic effort, concentration, and wisdom. For the sake of all beings, may we realize and demonstrate our innate goodness. In Buddha, Dharma, and Sangha, we go for refuge until fully awakened. Through the power of generosity, ethics, patience, enthusiastic effort, concentration, and wisdom. For the sake of all beings, may we realize and demonstrate our innate goodness.
The great yogi Milrepa sang, "My body is the holy mandala itself, wherein resides the Buddhas of all three times. With their blessings, I'm freed from all needs and attachments. By day and night, I offer them up. Happy am I to do without material things, knowing that all beings in the six realms of samsara are inherently Buddhas, and all the three worlds, the self-creating, measureless Trikaya palace. Whatever I do is the play of the Dharma Dhatu, ultimate reality. Whoever I'm with is the Yidam deity. Wherever I stay is the Buddha's abode. Happy am I to forego outer supports, rituals, and symbols." So as we get started this morning, we'll do a little chanting. And for those of you, if you have not chanted before, think of it as singing. And if you don't like singing, think of it as making noise. And this is about the present experience of making sound and vibration, receiving sound and vibration. So even if you're not really into the tune or the sound, just pay attention to how it feels to make and receive this sound. I'm just going to chant Lama Cheno, which means calling in the Lama, awakening the teacher within each one of us. Yeah? Lama Cheno, 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 Lama Cheno.
Just
Gently focus your attention on your breath. Feeling the sensations of your body moving as you breathe. Sensation of the air moving in and out of your body. You can use this focused attention to stay in this moment each time you find yourself distracted in the past or the future. You can think about this moment, the breath in this moment. Remember, it's not how many times you get distracted, but how many times you come back that matters. Awakened awareness. So sit with natural body, not too tight, not too loose, upright, supported. Natural breath and energy, just breathing fully. At ease. A natural heart mind, open and curious, awake and aware. So remember, as we sit, there's nowhere else to go. Nothing else to do or undo. Nothing to accomplish. Nothing to achieve. You simply sit and breathe. Be in this wakeful moment.
May all beings everywhere with whom we are inseparably interconnected and who want and need the same as we do, may all be awakened, liberated, healed, fulfilled, and free. May there be peace in this world and throughout all realms of existence, an end to war, violence, poverty, injustice, and oppression, and may we all together complete the spiritual journey. So, thanks for surprising me, everybody. I thought I was going to be the only one here. I have a growing dislike for the time change, so, but I'm aware of it. That's the key, right? So, on the topic of awareness and awakening, since we're all awake an hour early today. So we've been talking a lot, our Foundations of Buddhism class is about halfway through, and we've been talking a lot about the structure and foundation of our
Buddha Dharma, the Buddhist teachings. And part of it, well, we'll start with the Four Noble Truths. If you haven't heard the Four Noble Truths before, it's that suffering exists in our experience, in our human experience. Suffering exists. Number two is that there's a cause for that suffering. It came from somewhere, it originated somewhere. Third is that there's a remedy or plan for remedy. And that that plan is the Eightfold Path, which, let me just summarize the Eightfold Path for you in the first of the Eightfold, the first of the Eight Noble Existences. And that's wise, complete, sometimes we hear it as right, wise and complete view and understanding. View and understanding of what? What? This human existence, this experience that we're in. So we're always practicing awareness and awakening in this moment of our human experience. Everything that's going on, including things like impermanence and interconnectedness. We often hear no self, and that's confusing, it's all get out. Let's call it interconnectedness. It means no self apart from other. So we're all part of the big experience. We're all in this. We're all part of this universe. We're not separate from it. So we endeavor every time we sit down and close our eyes and try to focus our attention and focus, you know, just as simply as focusing on the humanity of our breath. Without our breath, we don't have the body, right? We don't have the human experience. So we can focus on this life-giving experience that exists right here in this moment. Our breath isn't in the past. Our breath isn't in the future. I call it time traveling. So we just want to be right here, right now, and understand all the elements of what's going on. And it's great in this pristine little bubble where we can just listen to the crickets or the furnace turning on and off or our stomachs growling. But then as soon as we leave here and someone cuts us off in traffic, our awareness leaves and we start into a habitual pattern of response that's often unintentional. So we just get stuck right back into a habitual pattern of unconsciousness. Is that bad? No, it's human, right? It's very normal that we have responses and emotional responses. All of this is really about cause and effect, which I'll call karma. Everything had an origination. Stimulus and response, Think about all of the magical, mystical things that had to happen for each of us to even be in these precious human forms. Right? Just as simple as our parents had to get together. They had to meet. They had to like each other. Enough, at least. Right? And their parents had to meet. and like each other just enough. And their parents before that. And suddenly our tree is huge. All of those things that had to occur just for us to be in this body. Not to mention everything it's taken for you to be in this room and contemplating and understanding that's outside of our habitual stimulus and response. Understanding our part in it. And the great thing that happens from that is that we get to make conscious choices with that awareness. When we understand that opposing opinions doesn't mean good and evil, it doesn't mean the world will shatter. Means I understand my position and I understand you have a position as well. And they may be in conflict and I can understand that and be aware of my response because of that. So when we're in those tough moments, we're in tough times and scary things happen. I mean, don't watch the news, right? What did they say this week? It started with the time change. There's a full moon, and it ends with Friday the 13th. And there's coronavirus everywhere. Wash your hands, don't touch your face, right? That's not scary at all, right? And not to mention everything else that's happening. Just taking a breath and being simply aware of the fear that arises, the response that arises out of that primal fear. Just being awake and aware will allow you the opportunity to have a conscious action that comes out of that. And for me, sometimes that means the news is scaring me. 2020 kind of scared me last night. So I made an action to change the channel. I watched like an old rerun of Tattle Tales from like 1972. It was kind of fun. But sometimes we have to just remove ourselves from the fear and understand that that stimulus is not always the best thing to subject ourselves to. I often talk about my experience going to the beach. I love to go to the beach. I love the sound and the waves. And kind of my favorite part is like walking in, you know, just about ankle deep so you can feel that nice water like whooshing, 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 coming in and out. Taking the smells and the sounds and the warmth, and it's cool. My husband, however, wants to keep moving out in the water. And when you get about here, the waves start knocking you around. And it's quite uncomfortable. And I feel like I'm struggling to lose my balance. And I'm no longer enjoying the sounds and the smells. Instead, I'm trying to keep myself upright. So my choice is to move back to ankle or knee deep instead of chest deep and getting knocked around. I'm usually watching him out getting knocked around, but it's a conscious choice to move into the where you can control. You can't control everything. You can't control everyone else's thoughts or actions, But we can certainly change our own with awareness. Yeah. So your assignment this week is to check in often. Use something as a reminder. I like using a wrist mala and putting it on my right arm. I'm right-handed. So especially when I'm doing things like mousing around on my computer, that it clinks. It clinks on the desk and reminds me as it sort of gets in my way to be aware. So give yourself reminders. Put up a post-it note on your bathroom mirror that just says awake or kind. Allow yourself to have some intentional control of your actions and how you show up. Yeah? So as we close this morning, I think there's snacks and coffee out here too. I put a little extra coffee in today, so call it an offering. So we'll read the four dharmas of Gampopa and Longchenpa, followed by the passing on prayer and the bodhicitta dedication. Once in Tibetan and three times in English. Bless and empower us that our minds and hearts turn toward the Dharma. Bless and empower us that our Dharma practice becomes the path. Bless and empower us that the path truly dispels confusion. Bless and empower us that the confusion itself dawns as primordial awareness, Rigpa. When the sunset of this life arrives and its twilight shadows fade away, while dreams of the next begin to appear more vividly, may the inner light essence of the Buddha and all the radiant awakened ones continually guide us onwards and upwards on the path of spiritual enlightenment, through better and better rebirths until all are likewise illumined. May we unerringly realize the great path of the rainbow light body, transferring our current consciousness into timelessness time, this ever-present moment, the ever-fresh wakefulness and immediacy of the supreme state of Rigpa, Buddha mind. Jong Chuk Sem Chogrim Po Che Mak Ye Panam Ye Gyur Chi Ye Panyam Par Me Payong Gong Ne Gong Du Pelwar Sho. May the pure, brilliant sun of bodhicitta dawn in each and every heart and mind, dispelling the darkness of suffering and confusion unstoppably until all are illumined and awakened. May the pure, brilliant sun of bodhicitta dawn in each and every heart and mind, dispelling the darkness of suffering and confusion unstoppably until all are illumined and awakened. May the pure, brilliant sun of bodhicitta dawn in each and every heart and mind, dispelling the darkness of suffering and confusion unstoppably until all are illumined and awakened. Sentient beings are numberless. We vow to liberate them. Delusions are inexhaustible. We vow to transcend them. Dharma teachings are boundless. We vow to realize them. The Buddha's enlightened way is unsurpassable. We vow to embody it. Thanks for coming, all you Buddhas. Have some snacks and coffee and hang out. There's a donation tub out back here and one with the coffee as well. We appreciate anything you can drop. It helps us to pay our slight bills. Thank you.
Yeah. I'm going to try to do this.
So I checked it out.